I love music. My day is never silent. From the radio I have on in the morning to the music I listen to on my way into work, I'm surrounded by it. Nothing compares to the experience of hearing music out in clubs, though. When I first moved to London as a teenager, I was suddenly swamped by genres I'd never heard of before. I cut my teeth on grime and later discovered bashment, dancehall and dub. When I was finally old enough to go to clubs and bars, the first places I went were the bashment parties in Brixton and one particularly dingy bar in Camden that always played Wiley. But as soon as I found these places, where I felt so at home and met so many like-minded people, they dried up. When I bumped into a club promoter of one of my favorite nights that had shut his doors earlier that year, I asked him what had happened. He said they'd been shut down after completing a Form 696. Police came to the conclusion from the information on the form that his parties were a risk. Form 696 is a type of risk assessment the Met gives venues planning to host certain acts. Live music such as open mic nights and indie bands are exempt. The form targets music using a pre-recorded backing track, DJs and MCs. It requires the names, addresses and contact details of the promoters and artists performing and, up until 2009, an estimated ethnic makeup of crowd at the event. It came to light later that the police had been using these forms as evidence that violent crime may take place at certain events and as such cancelled them before the event even happened. This WASNT just beloved local club nights. In 2010, grime artist Giggs had his tour cancelled on the advice of police, and P Money said he was removed from gig lineups because of information he provided on the form. Stormzy and JME have also been outspoken about it, and the culture minister, Matt Hancock, has quite rightfully said that this form is potentially stifling young artists within the city. The Met is now reviewing it, but will this come too late for a generation of artists when you are a young person starting out in music? Studio time can sometimes be unattainable. Performing at raves is how a lot of people developed their style and honed their skills before they became the recording artists we all listen to today. We also can't forget all the people, myself included, that benefit from these events. The connections we make with people over a shared love of music are essential in today's isolated society. Last year saw a record number of London clubs close their doors too. When dubious restrictions like Form 696 continue to penalize venues and the artists who perform in them, it is inevitable that we will only see less and less of the events that really stir people and possibly a decline the entire, wonderful music scene we have here today. What a sad city London will be without it. In Focus is a series celebrating Black History Month 2017. Stay tuned for articles throughout the month of October.